Idaho for decades has urged residents and visitors alike to clean, drain, and dry all watercraft and inspect them for invasive species that could be transported from waterways in other states. Idaho first detected invasive quagga mussel larvae last fall in the Snake River at Twin Falls, taking rapid steps to treat that stretch of river in hopes of stopping the invasive pest from spreading. Last week, we traveled to Twin Falls to see the State Department of Agriculture's second year of treatment on the midsnake up close and to learn what might happen if quagga mussels are allowed to reach other waterways in Idaho.
It's in the snake, but this is the first confirmed finding of the quagga mussel, not just in the state, not just in waters of Idaho, but in the entire Northwest United States of America.
They're filter feeders, they take out everything good, and they leave very little for other species, and so there's a huge impact on fish species. But in Idaho, we're really focused on the impact they would have for irrigation and power generation. So quagga mussel is attached to any hard substrate, to the river bottom, to turbines, to irrigation pipes, and they choke down an irrigation pipe almost to a trickle. So if you can imagine how hard it is for farmers and ranchers to do their job normally, think about the complications in a state that depends on irrigation if we can't get irrigation water through a line.
The mussels are so prolific. One adult can produce over 1 million offspring in a single year. So if you do the math, that's thousands every day. They can achieve over 30,000 individuals per meter squared of water, and they can attach to all surfaces, grow over 400 feet deep. And what they do is they essentially choke out all other life. They become 80 to 90% of all the life in this aquatic system becomes quagga mussel.
By the time we would know and you would visually be able to see an infestation, it's too far gone at that point. By the time we felt the repercussions, we can no longer treat. And so we're trying to treat before that point. But it is hard because you're talking about a species that reproduces at a microscopic level, and that's when we can really eradicate. That's when our best chances are.
Fortunately, we're just finding it right here. So quagga mussels between Twin Falls Reservoir downstream to Centennial Park. At that point, we worked with our treatment team on developing a treatment strategy to address the problem. That involves utilizing chelated copper.
When you look on paper and you say, yeah, this is just 8.6 miles of treatment, that sounds really simple, but as you kind of drive through it, it's quite a bit more. Lots of logistics, lots of moving pieces to make sure everything kind of gets to where it goes. Every day at 10 o'clock for the last few days, we've been kicking on a new section. So getting those all up, bringing all the water volume up to one part per million, every little section is unique and has its unique challenges to it.
Characteristics of water flow, a volume, species of concerns, usage, that all changes as you move even just 30 miles downstream or just 10 miles upstream.
This is an extension of the important work that we did on the river last year. This is not a part of the river that we treated, though, because there was no velager detections here in 2023, despite extensive sampling. But we are here to finish this important work.
Our goal, our mission, is to eradicate the quagga mussel and all life forms of it out of the snake and protect and restore this waterway and subsequently all the connected waterways in the Northwest U.S. This quagga mussel, this invasive species, is a blatant biowarfare threat to our precious natural resources.
If you enjoy Idaho, this should be a very big concern because this water touches everybody.
Yes, it's the snake, and yes, we're in Idaho, but it's such a much bigger mission. Multiple states and even Canada connect to this. If the quagga mussel is allowed to go unabated, it doesn't just impact the waters and the resources here in Idaho. It's everything that's connected downstream.
The details that are rolled out in a response like this come from the water body at that time, because we're going to have different challenges, say if we go up to the North Idaho lakes like Coeur d'Alene and Pend Oreille and Priest. We're going to have different challenges in Southeast Idaho like Bear Lake and Henry's Lake.
We have lakes in North Idaho that are so deep that it would be physically impractical or impossible to treat. You simply couldn't get enough product to make a treatment there. That's where we have to protect that precious water body. There's also other water bodies in the state that have species of concern or endangered species where we know that we wouldn't necessarily be allowed to make a treatment like this.
The more experts we can have at the table addressing issues that come up and finding solutions, the better, because that's how we're going to get the most robust treatment plan and be able to implement the plan safely, methodically, and really cause the highest level of mortality to the quagga mussels as we're progressing through the treatment.
Early detection and rapid response is the only way that you can work towards eradicating an invasive species.
Really, we're just maintaining, monitoring the copper levels throughout the treatment area, addressing any areas that need higher concentrations of copper brought up. And really, right now, we're fine-tuning where we're at on the treatment.
A ton of partners, whether it was Fish and Game, Department of Water Resources, Department of Parks and Recreation, all of those partners and those state agencies came to bear their expertise and their patience and their assistance to us to pull off something that seemed impossible. And Idaho Power was an incredible partner, local jurisdictions, all of those folks in 2023. We did something that was bigger and more expansive than anything anyone has ever attempted in North America. That was the 2023 project, and what we're doing in 2024 is even bigger than that.
I've never seen anything like it. We work all over the country. We work on eradication programs of invasive species all over the country and in a couple other countries too. I've never seen anything like this operation. I've never even heard of anything like this to target an invasive species in an aquatic resource like this.